Welcome to Traveler's Tales. I am your host, Greg Alonzo. Today I will be your guide through history as we take a look at who were the Bulgars. Before we begin, just a reminder that we post new videos every Tuesday and Friday. Don't forget to hit the little bell icon to be notified each time we post new videos. Moving right along, mythology tells us one thing, while archaeology tells us another. Who then were the Bulgars, and where did they come from? The origin of the Bulgars is still unclear. Their homeland is believed to be both Kazakhstan and the North Caucasian steppes. It is generally believed that the Bulgars were a Turkic semi-nomadic warrior tribe that flourished in both Pontic and the Caspian steppe, also along the Volga region. The Volga Tatars and the Chuvash people claim to have originated from the Volga Bulgars. However, some researchers believe that these semi-nomadic equestrian Bulgars' roots can actually be traced back from the Central Asian and perhaps having Iranian elements. Modern genetic research points to an affiliation with Western Eurasian and European populations. In fact, many of the early Bulgars inhabited the European steppe. It is generally believed that they were pushed there by the onslaught of the Huns. As the Bulgars became more and more sedentary, they became the political and military elite and established the first Bulgarian Empire. Subsequently, they merged with the established Byzantine populations as well as with the previously settled Slavic tribes. Eventually, the Bulgars became Slavicized, forming the ancestors of the modern-day Bulgarians. Originally, the Bulgars had the typical culture of the nomadic equestrians of Central Asia. They migrated seasonally in pursuit of good pastures as well as an attraction to the economic and cultural interaction with the sedentary societies. Coming into contact with sedentary cultures, they began mastering the crafts of blacksmithing, pottery, and carpentry. With regard to the religion of the Bulgars, very little is known. However, it is generally believed that they were monotheistic. In the Greek language inscriptions from pagan Danube, Bulgaria, Bulgar monarchs described themselves as ruler from God. This in itself indicated that their authority was derived from divine origin. The Bulgars were definitely a confederation of tribes that were spread throughout the Asian steppes. So what language did they speak? The origin of the language of the Bulgars is subject to debate. It is generally accepted that at least the Bulgar elite spoke a language that was a member of the Ughur branch of the Turkic family. Historians also concur that Chuvash was also a preferred language. Lastly, there is also general consensus that the now extinct Khazar was spoken. Finally, what was the standing of women in the Bulgar society? Typically, women enjoyed more rights and freedoms. They were mothers, wives, warriors, and shamans. As was commonplace among the steppe tribes, women were expert at handling and riding horses, as well as being well-versed in archery. This brings us to the end of part one of Who Were the Bulgars? Thank you for once again joining us for this edition of Traveler's Tales. Just as a reminder, we post new videos every Tuesday and Friday. Don't forget to hit the little bell icon to be notified each time we post new videos. For your convenience, we have also listed our email address and Instagram information. If you haven't done so already, please like and subscribe to Traveler's Tales. This really is the best way to help our channel grow. Traveler's Tales will return with Who Were the Bulgars? Part 2. Until we meet again at the crossroads of folklore and history, Karthistos.